Last night against the 76ers, we almost lost the game, and this is why, okay? Shvee with a nice offensive board, and then the OG gets an open free pointer, which would put them up by 8 in this crucial time in the fourth quarter. Doc Rivers has enough. He decides to put in Andre Drummond. Now up 5, OG goes inside, and Maxey here blocks the shot, and OG had to change his form so that Drummond doesn't block him in the rim. And Maxey here with a nice two-pointer. And next play down 3, you have Drummond contesting this shot to where now it's a miss, and now you have Philly going on transition. Harris to Korkmaz to Maxey, and Maxey gets himself a nice deuce here because Drummond obviously in the paint. He could have easily passed it to him, and then now Van Vliet puts up a free. Well, he misses that one. Philly is only down by 1 at this point, and Tobias Harris tries to put up a floater, and Drummond gets the offensive board and puts up 2 points. And the Sixers are now up by 1 now, and then the block of the game right here where Drummond gets his 4th block on Precious now. They had to challenge it, and I bet you this wouldn't have happened if Cambridge was in the game. Let me explain. So, it's no secret that last season when Evan Bane was at center, the Raptors were just down horrible, honestly. And it was a breath of fresh air when we had Cam Birch signed this team, and he was providing some great minutes right here. Being a starter in 17 of the 19 games he played last season, and his stats practically doubled. You see points being up by a lot, you see rebounds being up, offensive rebounds being up, field goal percentage, oh my goodness. He was just playing at a much higher level, and he was just giving us minutes that were desperately needed at the center position. And so it was expected that next season he was going to be the starting center, and he was going to thrive at that position, and we couldn't wait to see him play a full season for the Raptors. And unfortunately, after Kyle Lowry got traded, in comes a key acquisition in Precious Achiuwa that the Raptors could develop for years to come, and he was to be the starting center for the first part of the season. But if you watched any Raptors games this season, you would see Precious really struggling out there. He looks lost, he looks confused, and when Cam Birch would come in, a lot of those problems would go away and he would stabilize the Raptors on both ends. And one such game where you could see the effects of having Cam on the court was the game against Indiana, and Nick Nurse was even asked about it by a reporter.
But I think, again, the position, it's kind of what you got a couple guys there for. You know, you'd love them to share it and both play great each night and all that kind of stuff. But I think that's kind of what it is you see who's got it going or who's got a better matchup or who's got fresher legs or whatever the case may be. And tonight we needed Kim, you know, and he ran a lot more minutes.
One thing that Cam noticeably does better than Precious is screening, okay? These screens from Precious, guys are still able to go over the screen. Not much effect is being done. The guys are still beating him, and you have guys that are taking contested shots because of it. Now, Cam screens, on the other hand, you have him taking big screens, strong screens, very smooth. Guys can't beat him over the screen. And right here, Van Vliet gets an open shot, even though he misses. You have the luxury of having a player in Cam Birch taking those screens. And of course, coaches appreciate that part of the game more than anybody else.
Yeah, they've really got a good little combination going. And I give Cam a lot of credit there. He's really screening well, right? That's not that easy to always come up there and get the right angle and get Freddie some free space to play in. And, you know, he make a few timely little floaters here and there, and also a few timely offensive rebounds throughout the game.
Yes, this is a part of his game that people just don't quite see enough of. And he averages, in fact, for a bench player, the most offensive rebounds per game with 3.5 rebounds per game. And obviously, he averages the most offensive rebounds per game in the team itself. And he's part of the reason why they're able to get so much offensive rebounds. In fact, that they're number one in the league in offensive rebounding. And it shows when they played the Cleveland Cavaliers, although they did lose against them, him and Scotty Barnes out-rebounded both Evan Mobley and Jared Allen on the offensive rebounding. And oh boy, let's get into Scotty Barnes, because wow, he averages the most offensive rebounds per game amongst rookies, and the nearest person is Evan Mobley, and he's not even close. When Scotty Barnes has to play guys like the Celtics without Cam Birch at center, it's going to be much harder for him to get rebounds over guys like Horford and Robert Williams. And man, Robert Williams had 8 offensive rebounds in that second matchup they had. And boy, the difference was just so staggering, man. Ken Birch not being in the game, really a big factor. You could tell this team didn't have a center that could box out these two to get boards. Oh, and by the way, Robert Williams averages the most offensive rebounds per game amongst all players in the league. Yeah. Yeah, we really needed Ken Birch that game, man. Oh boy, it's just sad. And what makes it special is that Ken Birch was able to level up his game thanks to him going to Toronto, and he knows how lucky he is to have been given this opportunity.
I mean, I'm kind of lucky because I played Team Canada with Coach Nurse like 2 years ago, so it's basically the same concepts. And also, it's just like it's a common sense defense and a freedom on offense. As long as you play good defense, you get to do kind of whatever you want on offense. So, you know, as long as you play hard and use common sense, I think that kind of translates.
Thanks to the opportunity given to him by Nick Nurse, you have Ken Birch leveling up his game, and it really does seem like Ken Birch himself felt that this was an opportunity he desperately needed, because in Orlando, they weren't treating him the same way.
And but also, yeah, man, I just feel like playing with this team is, you know, I'm kind of getting out of the box. You know, I was in a box in Orlando, you know, not to be disrespectful. It's just, you know, I've been there. When I came over there, I was really raw. So I guess that's what they expected me to be. But I work on my game a lot. You know, the pandemic helped me out. I was in the gym a lot. And, you know, I always knew I could be doing this type of stuff. And you have me, I don't even think I'm at my full ceiling right now. I think I can do more. You know, I kind of have a little bit, I don't have as much confidence as I'm supposed to right now, but I'm gradually getting that right now.
And I do think that you can see how much better he is in terms of his confidence, in terms of how he plays. He's much more comfortable in the system, even though there's a lot of new faces in this team. He's one of those guys that stabilizes the defense. And without him, the defensive cohesion that the Raptors have is not there. And on the offensive end, you miss his screening, you miss his offensive boards. And really, that would have made a difference in that game against Boston. And I'm pretty sure they would not have given up that lead they had against the Sixers in that fourth quarter.